Hey, that's JB.
Brick Fanatic here. Guys, I'm outside today and we're going to be taking a look at the three helmet sets for April 2020. These sets retail for $60 each. And these are actually labeled for 18 plus, as you can see on the boxes. These guys are awesome and we're going to be taking a closer look at each of them. If you guys do enjoy the video, go ahead and leave a like down below and subscribe to the channel if you're new.
The first thing I want to get out of the way is the beautiful box art. If you just look at this, they each have this incredibly clean black box on the sides. You've got it all the way around. It shows some more details and features that the bust or the helmet might have. You've got some images on what would be the actual like versions of it down here, and then on the other side you actually have a 40th anniversary of Empire, signifying the 40th anniversary of Empire, and it says helmet collection on the top. These guys are super awesome. I really hope it's not windy right now because of the wind, but as you can see, these boxes are super clean and much larger. But another thing I will note is the size of the actual thing on the box is pretty similar to the size of the actual helmet. So if you're wondering how big the helmet's gonna be, it's gonna be about the size that it is on the box.
My favorite of the three is going to be the TIE Fighter Pilot. This one was the most fun to build and I think has the most aesthetics, and it's more aesthetically pleasing, I guess, to the eye. This one incorporated building techniques from both of these. The majority of the build is similar to the Stormtrooper here, where you get into this technique down here and then using these wheel pieces for, you know, the little breather things, the mask. And then you've got train wheels that go into the base, and it's just so cool. The little details on the front, including the sticker here, I got it to line up pretty perfectly. You have the eye in there, just all the different curves, and it uses shield pieces on the inside. You've got this printed dish on the top to represent the Empire. And then going around the sides, you can just see all the different details with the curve that goes all the way across the top. It just looks so nice, and this one is easily my favorite of the three. My second favorite is going to be the Stormtrooper, simply because it looks so good. I think it's because it's so beefy and there's a bunch of details all the way around. Like, you have the back little bits here on the side. You do have a bunch of stickers that go onto the side to give these details. Now, these stickers are different from these stickers because you can see this has a nice sloping effect that kind of follows this whole front curvature. And the build was so interesting getting all done throughout here. Again, you have the same sticker deal up here, sticker and a print, and it just lines up perfectly. I think the black line they did get around the edge is perfect for the top of the visor there. The third and final model here is going to be the Boba Fett helmet. This one is definitely the fan favorite. However, it is my least favorite, but seeing how awesome this thing is, it's kind of saying a lot calling it my least favorite because they're all incredible. This one has really cool techniques all along the side here, giving it this black stripe down the middle. Then you have the bright orange stripes going throughout the top just to be super accurate. And then around back, you do have even more little grill details that kind of just flush out the whole back. Now, his little thingy, I forget what it's called. I keep knocking this stand off. I have his antenna or his kind of scope laser thingy where he can see through people or whatever he does. The Mandalorian kind of went more into just how cool this thing really is. But all along the side, the building technique was phenomenal for it. And these builds are just so cool. I kind of like it better displayed like that too, but they all look fantastic. Again, the display stand here is on a 4x6 modified plate or tile. It's got Boba Fett, Stormtrooper, and TIE Fighter Pilot written on it. Again, this one's my favorite, this is my second favorite, and this is my third favorite just because of how they are. Now, something to note while building this thing is this base is actually rooted into the stand, if you will. So if you go into here, there's just a bunch of different, like, there's actually Technic beam on the inside. So this is not gonna fall off the stand anytime soon. These are incredibly well constructed and very hard. I could actually even do a drop test if you really wanted me to. So the only thing that fell off was the visor and then the stand. Not the visor, I keep saying the visor. I really don't know what it's called. But yeah, I mean, these guys are awesome. Drop test, nothing broke off. Like, I don't know. I don't really know what else to say. Like, these guys are incredibly tough. Let me see if I can get it to focus. I'm using an old card table that we used to use for painting. Yeah, these guys are not falling apart anytime soon, again, except for this thing, but that has a two stud connection. So there you go. There's a small little drop test. It wasn't a full drop test because I really don't want to ruin these things. These are display pieces. These aren't really play sets. Very difficult building techniques. Not really difficult, but they are 18 plus, I would say. Don't give this to your six-year-old expecting them to be able to build it. That's going to be it from me for today. I hope you guys did enjoy this super quick little review of all three of these guys outside in wonderful nature. If you guys did enjoy, go ahead and leave a like down below as well as subscribing to the channel, and I will see you guys in the next one.